Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn complete microservice architecture in Spring Boot. So today in this video, first I will create two microservices. One is store service and second is catalog services. So after creating these two microservices, I will register these two microservices with service registry, and after that I will create one API gateway. So all the requests come from the client will travel through API gateway, and to track the status of all the microservices or to return the fallback message if any microservices is down, we will use circuit breaker and resilience 4j library. Because sometime our microservices is not working or does not return response message in proper amount of time. So if we are not getting response back in particular amount of time, then we will call fallback API that will be notify which microservice is down. For that we will use resilience 4j, and we will also use distributed log tracing to track the request by log files, and we'll use the unique ID to track the request, that is the complete flow request through all microservices. For that we will use Zipkin and Salyut libraries, and we can use common place to hold common properties that will be used by multiple microservices. For that we will use cloud config server and will create one git repository. So we will save our all common configuration here in git repository, and will read by our config server and give it to our all microservices like store microservice and catalog service. So if we do changes at one place, then it will affect to our all microservices. So okay, let's get started. First we will create two microservice. One is a store service and second is catalog service. Okay, first I will create one store service. So here I will go to my Eclipse and also go to web browser. And here I will just type start.spring.io, and here I will select Maven project language Java, and Spring Boot version is 2.5.5, that is latest. And here we need to define group ID, so here I will define com.gainjavaknowledge, and here we need to define artifact ID, so here I will define store service. And the next we need to select Java version that we want to use, and in the next we need to add the dependencies. So here I will add Spring Web dependency because we need to create REST APIs, and second we need to add Spring Data JP. So we will create JP repository to insert and fetch the record from database. And another dependency that we need to add MySQL driver because we will connect with MySQL database. And next we can add Lombok dependency. So these are the four dependencies that we need to add. So here I will click on generate. Now here I will extract this file and open this folder and copy the path and go to my Eclipse. And here I will go to my store service and file import Maven project, existing Maven project, browse and click on finish. So our project is started to import, and so project has imported. Now I will open source main Java, it's our main class, and inside source main resources there is application.properties file. And here I will use application.yml file. So I will create one file that is application.yml, and click on finish. So application.yml file is ready. So first here we'll create a few more packages, that is new class. First I will create controller package, and the class name will be store controller, and click on finish. And next I will create one service package, न्यू पैकेज सर्विस एंड इनसाइड सर्विस पैकेज आई विल क्रिएट इंटरफेसेस दैट इज स्टोर सर्विस एंड नेक्स्ट आई विल क्रिएट वन इम्प्लीमेंटेशन फॉर दिस इंटरफेस. So here I will create service.impl and the class name will be store service impl and next I will create one repository that is store service.repository and inside this I will create one interface that is store repository and here it's not class it will be interface and it will extend our JPA repository extends JPA repository but before that we also need to create our model class that is our entity class. So now I will create one more package that is entity package. So here I will just type entity and class name will be store and finish it store entity. So first I will go to our store entity class. And here I will just add few properties that is ID and name of the store and location of the store. And here I will import javax.persistence.id and here I will use @data_annotation_of_lombok @all_arg_constructor @no_arg_constructor. So these are the annotations. And this is our entity class. So here we also need to define @entity annotation. And here we will define the table name @table annotation. And name will be store. javax.persistence table. So save it. So after creating our entity class, I will go again to my repository. So first I will refresh it. And here I will go to my repository package and store repository and here we just need to define our entity name that is store entity and the data type of primary key is integer. So here I will define it. So after creating this repository I will go to my controller class. So here I will just define annotation @restController to make our class as a controller and here I will use @requestMapping annotation. So here we can define the base path for all the API. So that will be store and next here I will create two REST endpoints. One will be used to save the store detail and second will be used to fetch the store details by ID. So first will be used to store public store create store and here I will pass @requestBody that will be our entity class store entity so here store entity and the next I will auto void. Here I need to inject our service layer here. So here I will use auto void annotation private store service and set our service. So after creating the object for store service. So here I will just call store service dot create store and we'll pass the reference variable here that is store. So here we just need to return store entity Now what I will do, here I will create the method. So after creating this method inside interface, now we need to provide the implementation for this method. So here I will go store service impl, and here we need to implement store service, and here I just need to add unimplemented methods, and here I also need to inject our. So here first I will define @ServiceAnnotation, so its object will be create, and here I need to inject our repository class. So what I will do, here I will use @AutoWireAnnotation and store repository, and we'll use this store repository, and we'll call save method, and we'll pass our entity class here, that is store. So once it will save the object into database, it will return the same object to our API response back. Now I will go to my controller again, and we'll create one more REST endpoint that will return the response back to my, that will get all the store details. So here I will just define @PostMappingAnnotation. And here we can define the URL save, and now I will create one more REST endpoint that will be get type. So we will get the store detail by a store ID. So it will be get public store entity get store by ID, and here we need to define annotation, that is @path variable, and need to pass string ID. So here what I will do, return store service dot find by ID, and the ID will be integer. So here I will change the data type, and here I will just pass the store ID, and need to use the same parameter name here. Now I will create method. So now I need to provide the implementation to this method. So here I will need to add unimplemented method inside our implementation class. So here what I will do, I will just copy this store repository and need to call find by ID. And here we need to call get method, because we are getting optional object. So these are the two REST endpoints we have created. Now I will start my application and will test it. But before this, we also need to add our database connectivity configuration here in application.yml file. So here first I will just define the port number, server port, that is 8080. And here also need to add one space. And next we also need to define our Spring application name that will be used while we register our service with Eureka server. And next we need to define the name of our Spring application. So here I will define store service. And these are the database configuration. That is data source. We are using driver class name MySQL JDBC driver, and I have created one store DB inside our Heady SQL. So we can see here store DB, and it's just empty. So it will create table automatically. So I have defined here Hibernate DDL auto is update, and this is a username and password for our local database. Now I will just start the application and test it. Run as Java application. So here it is showing some error that failed to determine suitable driver class. So first I will update it. Maven update project. Update the project and click on force update. Okay. Now I will try to run it again. Run as Java application. So now here we can see our application has started. So now I will go to Postman and will test our both API. One will be used to save the store detail and second will be used to get the store detail by ID. So here we can see in DB. I will refresh it and will check the table. Table is created and there is no data in the table. So let's open first Postman. So this is the URL post API and localhost 8080 store slash save, and inside body I am just passing the name and location. So here I will hit. So in response we can check I am getting one response body and we will take it upon, and ID is 4. Now I will go to get API. So here I will just hit this API and will pass the primary key as 4. So our store ID is 4. Now I will send it. So here we are getting the response. So we can say our REST APIs are working fine. Now I will create one more microservice, that is catalog service. So now we need to create catalog service that will be the same. So first I will go here in start.spring.io and just change here artifact ID, that is catalog service, and we'll use the same dependency that we have used in our store service: Spring Web, Spring Data JP, MySQL Dropper and Lumbo. So click on generate. So here our service has generated. Just extract it here, open, copy the path and go to our Eclipse and file, import existing Maven project and just paste and finish. Here we can see our catalog service has imported successfully, and now we need to create more packages because here we also need to create two APIs. One will be used to store catalog details and second API will be used to fetch catalog details along with store details. So it will call catalog API and also store API. So here I will just create one package, that is controller. Dot controller, and the class name will be catalog controller, and here I will just define the annotation at the rate rest controller. And here I also using at the rate request mapping annotation to define the base path for all the API. So here I will just define catalog, because here we can see I have used store and catalog as the base path for our APIs. And next I will create our service layer. So here I will create one interface inside our service package and our catalog service. And for this service I will create one implementation class, service impl, and the class name will be catalog service impl, and click on finish. So here I just need to define annotation, that is at the rate service. So Spring will understand and create the bean for this class. And here we need to implement the interface, that is catalog service interface. Catalog service interface. And now we also need to create entity class. So here I will go and create new class, that is entity class inside entity package, and entity class name will be catalog entity, and click on finish. So here we also need to create the repository class, new class. So that will be repository class inside our repository package, and catalog repository. So this repository will be the interface, and here we just need to implement extends JP repository, and here we just need to define our entity name, that is catalog entity, and the second parameter will be the data type of our primary key, that is integer. Now I will go to controller back, and here we need to create one more package, that is modal package. So here I will create a new package, that is modal package, and inside modal package we need to create two classes. One will be the store classes, that entity class we have created in our store service microservice. So what I will do, I will go to our store and will copy from here store entity and just copy the data from here and go to our catalog service, and inside our store model class I will paste it. Why we are creating this class here? Because when we will, here we are going to create two REST endpoints. One will be used to save the catalog details into DB, and the second will be used to fetch the data from database. So when we will create second REST API, that is get, in this API we will get store detail and also get the catalog details. So here I will use @data annotation, so no need to create setter getter, and here all work constructor, and also need to create no work constructor. So this is our model class, and here we also need to create one more model class. That class will be our store catalog response, because from our catalog API we will also call our store API. So here what I will do, here I will just define two attributes, private store store, and the second will be private catalog entity catalog, and here I will use same @data annotation, @all arg constructor, @no arg constructor. So these are the three annotations. We can also use other annotation according to our requirement. So what I will do now, I will go to my controller class. So first I will refresh it here. So its structure will be formatted. Now inside our controller class, I will go to catalog controller. So here I will create two REST endpoint. One will be used to store our catalog details, public catalog entity create catalog, and here we just need to pass @ request body, and request body will be our catalog entity. So we are not creating more model catalog, and here what we need to do, here we just need to inject our service layer. So here I will use @auto void and private catalog service कैटलॉग सर्विस एंड जस्ट नीड टू कॉपी दिस एंड हियर वी जस्ट नीड टू कॉल रिटर्न कैटलॉग सर्विस डॉट क्रिएट कैटलॉग एंड हियर वी जस्ट नीड टू पास आवर एंटिटी क्लास एज ए रेफरेंस वेरिएबल एंड हियर व्हाट आई नीड टू क्रिएट कैटलॉग मेथड इनसाइड आवर सर्विस लेयर एंड फॉर दिस वी आल्सो नीड टू प्रोवाइड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन लेयर सो हियर आई विल गो टू कैटलॉग सर्विस IMPL एंड जस्ट नीड टू प्रोवाइड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन फॉर अनइम्प्लीमेंटेड मेथड्स After adding this, here we just need to inject our repository class catalog repository. Now what I will do, catalog repository dot save method we need to call. So this function will save our entity inside DB. And we'll return the same object. So what we need to do now, I need to create one more REST endpoint that will return me the detail of catalog and also will return the detail of stores in same API. Same API will fetch all the details. So here I will use @postMapping and save is the URL. And the next here I need to use @getMapping and here I will define catalog ID. So here get store catalog detail and here we need to use store catalog response and here we need to define @path variable so we will get the id from our path variable that will be integer and here we need to define the same name that is catalog id and here we just need to pass the same id and find by id. Now what we need to do, here I will go and create the method find by id and now we need to provide the implementation for unimplemented method. So I will go to our implementation layer and here I have just added unimplemented method. So now I will copy catalog repository and here I will just call find by id and here we just need to pass our integer id. Now we also need to fetch the store details and to fetch the store details what we need to do, we need to call REST API of store microservice. So here we need to call store service REST API. So here we need to create REST template bean. So where I will go to main class and inside our catalog service implementation main class I will just create the bean of REST template. So here I will just define @bean annotation and private REST template. So REST template of web client REST template and it will return new REST template. So it will return the bean of REST template. So after creating the bean of REST template, we need to inject into our implementation class. So here what I will do, here I will just inject our REST template bean auto void private REST template. And here what I will do, here we need to call REST API of store service that is get by id. So here get for object and here we need to pass the url and other is response type, that is store.class. And here I will import it, and inside our catalog entity, and here I have added three properties in our catalog entity, that is ID, name and store ID. So now I will go back to our catalog service IMPL, and here we just need to define the URL of store service API, that is get by store ID. So open to Postman, and this is the URL. So here I will go to our YAML file. Source main resources, first I will create here application.yml, and we also need to use the same properties and configuration for our database connectivity. So I will go to our store service and will copy the same YAML file from here. So copy it from here and go to our catalog service and paste the same application.yml file here. So now I will go here, and here I just need to define get store API URL that we need to copy from our Postman. So I will copy it from here and paste it here and save it. Now I will go back to our service IMPL layer, and inside service IMPL I will just define @value annotation, and here I will define the property name, and based on the property name we will get the value get store URL private string get store URL. Import this annotation, paste it here, and here we just need to call get method. So we will get the object of catalog entity here, and from catalog object we will get store ID. So here I will copy catalog, and after URL we need to pass get store ID. So from this API I will get store object and will return the new store catalog response as the object, and here I will store and catalog as a parameter. So these are the APIs. So now I will go to my catalog service, and first I will show you my application.yml file and remove the application.properties file. And in application.yml file I just need to change our application name, that will be catalog service, and here we need to change database, that is catalog db, and here get store url, everything is done. We need to change its port number because 8080 is already in use by store service. Now we will start our catalog service run as Java application. @bean method rest template must be private or final. So here we just need to change the scope of bean so it will be public, and start the application again. So here we can see our application has started, and in get API we are calling our get catalog API, and also internally we are calling rest store service API, that is get by store ID. So I will go to Postman. So first I will store, add one store. So here catalog and inside body I will just pass two properties, name and store ID, and will send. And in response we can check 200, okay, and our catalog is stored into database with ID 2. Now I will go to get catalog by ID, and here I will pass catalog ID is 2 and send it. So here in the response we can check 404 not found. So here we need to use curly braces, then it will accept it as a path variable. Now stop the server and start it again. So here we can see our application has started, and now we'll go to Postman and we'll hit get by catalog ID. And now, so here we are getting 500 internal server error, so we need to check in our database. In catalog there is service ID is 1, but in store if we go here, store ID 1 is not available, so we just need to change it and need to hit the same rest endpoint again. So here we are getting the proper response, and this is the proper response. Here we can see the store object and we can also see the catalog object. So now our two microservices has ready. So now what we need to do, we need to register these two microservices in service registry. So now I will create one more project, that is Spring Boot project, and we'll register both microservice in service registry. So why we need service registry? Because when the number of microservices in the application increases, so it is difficult to manage in configuration file. So that service registry came into picture, and it helps to resolve multiple problems, like to register a service we can use, and when a new service becomes online it registers itself to the service discovery service with its IP and port. So we do not need to remember its IP and port, we can check the detail on server. And it also helps service to find other services, and like we can see multiple services on single screen. And health check to check the health of instance, and add to remove when it is not well. So we can also check the status of services if it is up or down. If we want to remove service directly, we can remove it from here. And next we can also deregister when service becomes offline. So thus it helps to utilize the full capability of the cloud to dynamically scale and shrink based on the requirements, and also make the architecture loosely coupled to each other. So now we will create service registry and we'll register our microservices and check their details on Eureka server. So okay, let's create one Spring Boot project. Go to browser, and here just I need to change our artifact ID. So artifact ID will be service registry, and next we need to add dependencies. So first I will remove this dependency that we have already added. Remove this. So we just need to add only single dependency, that is Eureka server dependency that we need to add, and click on generate. So it's generating, and extract it here, and need to copy the path of service registry and go to Eclipse, and need to import existing Maven project. Finish. So here our project is imported successfully, and now I will go to my main class, and in our service registry main application here we just need to enable Eureka server. So here I will just define the annotation @enable Eureka server, enable Eureka server. It's not showing here in Eureka server. So after imported this annotation, Now I will go to my application.yml file. So here I will go source main resources and just need to create new file, that is application.yml file. So here application.yml file, and need to remove application.properties, delete it. Okay. And inside our application.yml files, first we need to define server port, and the default port number for our Eureka server is 8761, so I will use the same. And here I need to enable Eureka client. Need to disable the Eureka client because it is Eureka server, this is not Eureka client. So what we'll do, register with server with Eureka, register with Eureka, it will be false. And next we need to define fetch registry is also false, fetch registry, it is also false. Why we defined here it's false? Because the Eureka client will be the application of service that we want to register on Eureka server. And here we are just creating Eureka server and not creating Eureka client, so we make it is false. And when we go to make Eureka client, in that case we need to make it as true. So as we know, our store service and catalog service will be Eureka client, so I will make it as true in our store service YML file and catalog service YML file. So here these will be false because this is Eureka server. Because we do not want to register itself, so here it will be false. So now what I want to do, I want to make our store service and catalog service as a client. So first I will update it, Maven update, it's showing subreddit sign, force to update. Okay, so now it's looking fine. Now I will go to my store service class, store service microservice, and inside store service, and we need to register our store service into Eureka server. So first I will go to store service, and inside store service I will go to my pom.xml, that is store service pom.xml. And here we just need to add the dependency of Eureka client. So I will go to browser, and here we'll just add Eureka client. So search here Eureka client, Eureka discovery client, and explore it here. And here what we need to do, so here I will copy it from here and go to notepad. So here also we can check the Eureka client dependency, so that we will copy it from here. So here where is the Eureka client, so I will copy this dependency from here and go to my store service pom.xml, that is my store service, and we'll paste it here. And also need to copy its dependency management and version. So what I will do, I will just copy its dependency management and copy the dependency management from here, dependencies, Spring Cloud dependencies, and copy it from here and go to our pom.xml. And now after dependencies, before build, we just need to paste it. And now we just need to copy the Spring Cloud version. So what I will do, I will just go to my properties, and from properties I will copy the version, and here I will go to properties and just paste it here, so it will manage the version. Now I will just update it. And the same dependency that we need to add in our catalog service. So I will just go to our catalog service. And inside catalog service, I will open my pom.xml. catalog service pom.xml, and here we just need to go to properties and just paste the version. After pasting the version here, we just need to copy the Eureka client dependency also from store service. So here I will go and search for Eureka client. Just copy this dependency from here and go to catalog service and we'll paste inside dependencies. So this is a Eureka client dependency we have added. Now we need to add dependency management. So it will manage the version and dependency for Eureka client. Copy it from here and go to our catalog service. Now go under dependencies and before build we need to paste it. So we have added Eureka client dependency in our both microservices, that is store service and second is catalog service. So after adding the Maven dependency in both microservices, we need to add some configuration in application.yml file for both the store service and catalog service. So first I will go to our store service and we can also go to catalog service anyone and open application.yml file, and here we just need to define the configuration to make it as a Eureka client. So what we'll do, I will go to service registry and copy it from here. Now I will go to our catalog service and we'll paste it here and make it is true because this service will act as Eureka client. So Eureka client will be true. And here we also need to define service URL, that is the URL that we have defined inside our service registry, that is service server port 8761. So now I will go to my catalog service and here I will just define service URL, service-url, and default zone, and here we just need to define HTTP localhost 8761 /Eureka/, and next we need to define instance and host where we are running our application. We are just running our application at local environment, so host name will be local. If we are running our application at production, then it will be different. Local host. So same configuration I will copy it from here and also use in our store service. Now I will go to my store service and will paste the same configuration here. So now both service will act as a Eureka client. So now I will stop both the services and Eureka catalog service and store service. So stop it. So first I will, and we also need to add one annotation, that is aggregator load balanced, that we have need to use in our catalog service because in our catalog service we have created our REST template bean. So after registering our both the microservice at Eureka server, we need to use load balanced. So here I will use load balanced. If you will not define load balanced annotation, then our request will not process from catalog to store service after registering our microservice on Eureka server. So now I will go to our service registry and start the application, and here we can see the port number 8761. Run as Java application. So here it's showing duplicate key Eureka. Now I will go and check our application.yml file. And here we can see Eureka client register. So here we no need to define this configuration. This configuration is for Eureka client, not for Eureka server. So remove it from here. And check to store service we have added. एंड वी नीड टू एड हियर दैट इज सर्विस रजिस्ट्री गो टू स्टोर सर्विस एंड चेक इट्स एप्लीकेशन डॉट वाई एम एल फाइल हियर वी हैव नॉट एडिड सो वी जस्ट नीड टू एड यूरेका क्लाइंट कॉन्फिगरेशन हियर एंड ऑल्सो नीड टू चेक कैटलॉग सर्विस अगेन टू कन्फर्म वी हैव एडिड और नॉट सो हियर यू कैन सी वी हैव एडिड सो वट विल डू फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट अवर सर्विस रजिस्ट्री रन एज मेन क्लास जावा एप्लीकेशन एंड हियर वी कैन सी यूजिंग एग्जाम्पल डिकोडिंग कोडेक कैन नॉट डिटरमाइन लोकल होस्ट नेम सो अवर एप्लीकेशन हैज स्टार्टेड एट पोर्ट नंबर 8761 सो गो टू ब्राउजर एंड जस्ट कॉल लोकल होस्ट 8761 सो हियर वी कैन सी इट्स अवर यूरेका सर्वर and here we can check system status and we can see here instances currently registered with Eureka here we can see there is no instance registered with Eureka so what we'll do now I will start my store service it is our catalog service so I have started and now I will go to store service and we'll start it also So here we can see our store service is started. Now I will go to our Eureka server and refresh it. And now I will go to instance currently registered in Eureka. So need to wait, refresh it again. So here we can see catalog service has started. So it's showing registered service here. Now refresh it again. So here we can see our both microservices has been registered on Eureka server as a Eureka client and this is a local host and its port number 801 and for store service the port number is 8080 so we do not need to remember its host name and port number everything will be managed by Eureka server after service registry and now we no need to use its host name and port number to call REST API of another microservice so we can just use directly the service name is catalog service or store service so as we know inside our catalog service we are calling store service API so here I will go to catalog service and inside our catalog service we are calling store service get store by ID API so here if we can use now our service name directly no need to use host name and its port number so here I will just define store service store hyphen service that is our application name so we can check it from here store hyphen service so we have defined inside our catalog service now I will stop it and start the application again and we'll check if it's working fine or not So start the application. So now no need to define host name and port number. So we can directly use the service name. So now I will go to my postman. And after application has started. So here I will just call the API. Get catalog by ID. And it will also fetch the detail of store after calling store API. So send it. And here we can see the store detail as well as catalog detail in single API. So it's working fine that we have defined here. We can directly call our microservice REST API direct by using service name only. No need to define host name and port name. So here we can see we have used the annotation that is at the rate load balanced because at the rate load balanced annotation we need to define our bean forest template in our catalog service Because if we are using multiple microservices and these are registered with Eureka service registry, then it will load the balance request. So main use of this annotation is to load balance the request that is coming to Eureka server and our microservices. So now next what we will do, now we need to create API gateway. So when the client will send the request, so it will traverse through our API gateway and then it will pass to our microservice by checking appropriate URL. So now we will create one more Spring Boot project and we'll define our API gateway. So okay, let's go to our browser and open start.spring.io, and here we just need to create a project that is API gateway. So here I will just type API gateway. And here I just need to click and add the dependencies. So here our API gateway will act as our Eureka client. So first I will add here dependency for Eureka client, Eureka discovery client, and second we need to add gateway dependency, that is Spring Cloud Routing, and the another dependency that we need to add is actuator, that is Spring Boot actuator dependency. So here we have added three dependencies. First is Eureka Discovery Client, second is Gateway, and third is Spring Boot Actuator. Now we'll generate it. And here I will just extract my API gateway.zip file and we'll open the folder and copy the path. Now I will go to my Eclipse in another workspace that I have created already, API gateway. So here I will just click on import and maven existing project, just paste the path, browse and finish. So here our API gateway project has started to import. So as we know, we are going to add API gateway because before API gateway our request directly passed to our microservice, but after adding API gateway our request will traverse through API gateway, then it will go to specific microservices based on its URL pattern. So when the client will send the request, first it will go through API gateway and after that the request will traverse through particular microservices based on its URL pattern. So in API gateway we will define the configuration for all the microservices. So now go here and our project has imported, that is API gateway. So first what I will do, I will create one application.yml file in our source main resources. So go here and click on file, new file, and define the name for file application.yml file and click on finish. So here we need to remove this application.properties that we are not going to use, so remove it. Now in our application.yml file we need to define the server port, in which port we want to run our API gateway. So API gateway Spring Boot project, so here I will define server.port and we have already used 8081, so here I will use port number 8082 and save it. And here we need to define the Spring application name, Spring application name, because we are going to register our API gateway as a Eureka client. So there we can see the name of our application, API gateway. So this is the, now we need to add more configuration to register our Eureka client with Eureka server. So I will go to our store service and we'll copy the configuration from there. So here I will go into store service application.yml file and we'll copy the configuration from here, and now we'll go to my API gateway and paste this configuration here. So now our API gateway will act as a Eureka client. So when I will start this application, it will also, we can see here on Eureka server, because first there are only two applications, that is catalog service and second is store service. Now API gateway will be act as Eureka client. So after adding this configuration, now we have to add configuration for our all microservices. So we have to do routing configuration in our API gateway service. So what we need to define? We need to define like this. If any request that contains slash store in URL pattern will be redirected to store microservices. If any microservice and if any URL contain slash catalog in URL pattern will be redirected to catalog microservices. That configuration we need to do in our API gateway. So here I will go to my API gateway and click enter. So here I will go and need to add cloud routes, cloud gateway routes, and next we need to define the routes, like how many endpoint routes contains list of different routes. So it will contain ID and we can define any name. So here I will define store service, ID will be any string value, and we need to define the URI. So here I will just type URI and need to define LB, that is load balancer, and store service, that is the service name. Service name that will be the same we need to use, and also we need to define predicates, and inside predicates we need to define the paths. So predicates, and inside predicates we will define the path. Based on this path the request will traverse to particular microservice. So path will be slash store slash star star. And like this we need to copy the same configuration and need to use for the catalog microservices also. So I will just paste it here and need to change the ID. So it will be catalog service, and here also need to change service name, that is the catalog service, and the URL pattern for catalog service is catalog that we have defined at our class level by using request mapping annotation. So LB here stands for load balance, and the predicates that is defined here, it contains the path information. If any URL start with slash store, that will be redirected to our store service, and if any URL pattern contains slash catalog, it will be redirected to our catalog service. Now we need to stop first our service registry, and here I will go and stop our service registry and also stop our all services like catalog services, and one more service that is store service. We can also stop this service, and now we need to restart. First I will start our service registry. So after starting it, we need to start other services, that is Eureka client services like store service, catalog service, and API gateway service. So once it will be start, then we will start our other services. So here we can see our service has started. Now I will go and start our API gateway, and we need to check first it's working fine or not. So here, application has started. Now we also need to start our store service and catalog service. So I have started store as well as our catalog service. So once this service will start, we can see here our all services that have registered with the Eureka server. So here unknown, need to refresh it again. And I need to check my API gateway application.yml file. I have defined our service name Maven update project because it's showing some red sign. So just need to update it will be. So go to application.yml file and need to check application name I have defined here. So need to refresh it again. So here we can see our application has started. API gateway catalog service and store service. And one more is that is unknown why it's showing here. So here we can see our three application has registered and we can see here on Eureka server. So now what we need to do? We need to test our REST API. And here we can see our API gateway service is registered at port number 8082. So now we can call our service through port number 8082. And then API gateway will be responsible to traverse the request to particular microservice based on its URL. So now I will open the Postman and test our microservice. So here I have opened it and need to test our service. So I will test get by catalog ID. So here we are using port number 8082 that we have defined for our API gateway. So that we can check also here. For API gateway, we have defined port number 8082. So now I will use 8082 and send the request, that is get. Or here it's showing 50 internal server error, and in catalog we have just only single ID, that is 2. So we just need to pass 2 as a catalog ID. Now we will check and we are getting the response fine. So we can see our API gateway is working fine. And so now my API gateway is working fine and all the requests are traversing through API gateway using port number 8082. Okay, now after adding API gateway in our microservice architecture, now we need to add resilience 4j and circuit breaker. So next is resilience 4j circuit breaker. Now we are going to implement circuit breaker in our microservice architecture. So what circuit breaker will do it, and circuit breaker will identify which of the microservices are not working and will return the message to user like that the service is not working, because in our microservice architecture we have multiple microservices. So to implement circuit breaker we will use resilience 4j libraries and to check which services is running or not. So what we will do, we will go to our API gateway Spring Boot project, and inside our API gateway project we will open pom.xml, and here we need to add the Maven dependency for resilience 4j. And after adding the Maven dependency we will add fallback methods for our microservices and we'll also implement these methods. Now I will go to our browser and here Spring starter initializer, we need to add new dependency, that is resilience 4j, and explore it. So here I am adding resilience 4j libraries in our dependencies in API gateway Spring Boot project. So here I have added two Maven dependencies. One is Spring Cloud Starter Circuit Breaker Reactor Resilience 4j and second is Resilience 4j Spring Boot 2. So after adding these dependencies we also need to add fallback methods. So here I will create one controller and inside this controller I will declare the methods, and we'll also need to add some configuration inside our application.yml file. So first I will create a controller, that is fallback method controller and refresh it. So we can create a separate package for this, that is dot controller, and refresh it here and copy this fallback method controller class and drop it here. So we have moved our fallback controller method class to our controller package. Here I will just need to define the annotation, that is at the REST controller, to make our class as act as a controller class. And inside this controller class we need to define REST endpoint that will return appropriate message which microservice is down. So here I am just pasting two rest endpoint, that is get type, and there is nothing more. These are just returning one string value and its mapping is get mapping, and URL is store fallback and catalog fallback method. So here I have just returning the string value, store service is longer than expected, please try again later. And in catalog service there is also same message, catalog service is longer than expected, please try again later. So now I will go to our application.yml and we need to add few configuration for our circuit breaker. So here I will go, and inside our configuration file for API gateway we just need to define fallback method. So here what we need to do, here we just need to paste, and we'll just paste the filters here, and the name will be circuit breaker, and arguments is the service name, that is name store service, and in fallback URI we have defined the URL pattern for get mapping, that we have defined here store fallback, and this is the URL pattern store fallback, and for same we will add catalog service. We need to just copy this. So here I will just pasting the same for catalog service also. Filters get name circuit breaker, arguments name catalog service, and fallback URI will be the catalog fallback, that we can see here in our fallback methods, that is catalog fallback. So it will be redirected to this API once the service will be down. There is few more configuration that we can also add for our resilience for J circuit breaker. So here I am just adding few dependencies and configuration inside our application.yml file. So here I have defined resilience for J circuit breaker, its configuration, and here I have defined the default configuration. If I do not want to define this configuration for any microservice, so here I can just refer to this object. Base config will refer to default object, and this microservice, that is store service, will use this configuration, that is basic and default configuration I have defined. If we don't want to define this configuration, we can remove it from here and just define like this. Inside catalog service we have directly defined the sliding window size, minimum number of calls, and with the duration open states, that we will discuss each variable and each parameter later. And here I have also defined resilience for J time limiter. It means if store service is not getting response within 2 seconds, so it will return the fallback method response, that is we have defined here fallback methods. So like this, if catalog service is also not getting response in 2 seconds, then it will return the response by this API. So here we have defined the configuration for our API gateway and for circuit breaker with resilience 4J. Now I will start our application and check if it is working or not. So here I have started my API gateway. So here we can see application is going to start, and our application is going to start port number 8082. And first I will go to check at Eureka server if every instance is up and running. So here we can see API gateway, catalog service, and store service is working fine and status is up. Now what we will do, I will go to our service catalog and hit this REST endpoint get catalog by ID. So here what I am getting the response back from our API. Now what will we do, we will stop one service, that is store service. So I will stop this service. Now we'll hit our REST endpoint again get catalog by ID. When we call this API, this catalog API is internally calling our store service. But what we did here, we have stopped our store service. So from store service this API will not get the response. So now our fallback method should execute. So here we can see our fallback method has executed and we are getting the response catalog service is longer than expected, please try again later. And now we will check for get store by ID API. So here I will send it the request and we will check the response. Store services is longer than expected. So like this, our fallback method will execute and we can easily know which microservices is down. So now after implementing resilience for a circuit breaker in our microservice architecture, now we need to implement config server. So we need to define our configuration server. For this we will create one more Spring Boot project, and as we know, we can place our common configuration inside our config server. So we will place our common configuration inside GitHub, and our config server, that will be Spring Boot project, interact with GitHub and will get all the configuration, and then this configuration server will talk with all microservices. So in our code we can see that is our store service or catalog service, any service we can go, and we can notice here that our Eureka client configuration is common for multiple microservices. Inside store service we are using this, and inside catalog service we are using this configuration, and inside API gateway, means inside three microservices we are using this same configuration. So what we will do, we will copy this configuration from here and we'll place into at one common place, and we will get that from here. So now our Eureka client configuration is different in each microservice. So if there is any change, we need to do for default zone, and if the URL for Eureka server been changed, then we need to go in each microservices that has registered, and we need to change manually the port for each microservice inside application.yml file. But we have placed this common configuration at single place, then we just need to do change in single place and it will affect to all microservices. So what we need to do, we need to set one configuration server, and where we can place our all the configuration and can use in all the microservices. So here now we will create one config server and we'll add our all common configuration in GitHub repository. We can use any repository, and our all microservices will talk with them config server. Now I will create one more Spring Boot project. So first I will go to browser and start.spring.io. So here what I will do, first I will remove these dependencies from here and just need to change the project name. So here I will define at a config server, and which dependency we need here. So first we need to add the dependency of Eureka client, because we need to register it as Eureka discovery client, and one more dependency, that is config server, also we need to add. So here we just need to add two dependencies, config, so add this one config server. So here we can see we have added two dependencies, Eureka discovery client and second is config server, and generate this project. And here we will extract config server.zip file and we'll open it and copy the path and go to Eclipse and just need to import existing Maven project. Just paste the path, click on browse and then finish. So our project has started to import. One more thing that we need to do, we need to create one new repository on GitHub, and there we will store our all configuration. So I will go to browser and here we'll just open GitHub, and here I just need to create a new repository, that is config server, and just need to click on create repository. So our repository has been created. Now after creating new repository, here I just need to create one new file. So here I will create new file. So file name will be application.yml file, and here we need to add the content for this file. So I will go our store service and catalog service, any service, and this is the common configuration file. This is a configuration that is commonly used for multiple microservices, and I will go back to my application.yml file and paste it here. So after pasting it here, now I just need to commit the changes. So this is a configuration that is commonly used for three microservices or four microservices. So just click commit new file. So now our file has committed the code. Now I go back to my config server, and here also I need to create one application.yml file inside our source main resources. So just click on new, create file, and the file name will be application.yml, and here we just need to define the port number. So as we know, 8082 is already in use, so we will define the next number, that is 8083. And after defining the port number, we also need to define Spring application name. Spring application name, so that will be config server. And after defining the Spring application name, we need to define cloud config. So here I will just define cloud config, and inside cloud config, that will be for server, cloud config server. And here we need to define our git URL, git URL URI, that we need to define. And here we need to define clone on start, clone on start, and here it will be true. So this is a configuration that we need to define for our config server. Now it's showing some red sign, so just need to update Maven update project. Click OK. So updating the Maven project. So now it's not showing any red sign. Now what we need to do, now our each microservices need to talk with config server. So we need to enable config client in each microservices that want to talk with our config server and want to use configuration from our common config server. Okay, let's go and add the particular dependencies in our store service first. So first I will go to our store service and go to pom.xml. Inside our pom.xml, now first I will stop the server. And so here we need to add Spring Cloud Starter config. So I will go to my config server, and here we need to go pom.xml, and inside pom.xml we have added the config server Maven dependency. So just need to copy this dependency from here, just copy it and go to each microservices that want to communicate with our config server. And we just need to paste this dependency here, and we need to paste in store service, also need to paste in catalog service. And we will stop this service and go to pom.xml, and just need to add the dependency here, that is config server dependency, because our cloud catalog service also want to communicate with config server for common configuration. And another is API gateway, also want to use the common configuration. So here what I will do, go to pom.xml, and also need to add the dependency. So here I have also added in three microservices I have added. So after adding these dependency in our all microservices, now what we need to do, now we need to add configuration in our application.yml file for each microservice that want to communicate with config server. So here we need to add the configuration. So this is the common configuration that we will read from our common place. So from here I will remove it and just need to go here, spring application name, and here what we need to do, here we add cloud, and inside cloud we need to add config, cloud config, and here we just need to enable it as a true, enabled colon true, and we also need to define the URI of our Git repository. So what is the URI that we need to copy, that is it. So here http localhost 8083, this is the port number that we have defined inside our config server. So we can check in our application.yml file for config server, we have defined the port number 8083. Now we will go back again to our catalog store service where we did changes. We did the changes in our API gateway. So we just need to copy this configuration. So this is the configuration that we need to add in our all microservices that want to communicate with config server. So we have already added in API gateway, and now we will go to our cloud service and open the application.yml, and inside under application name parallel to our application we just need to paste it here, cloud config enabled true, and this is the http localhost 8083. Now after adding catalog services we need to go our store service and also need to add configuration here so it can also communicate with our config server. So open the application.yml file, and parallel to our application we just need to paste it here, that is cloud config enabled is true and localhost 8083. So from here we also need to remove this configuration. This is the common configuration that we will read from our GitHub repository after connecting with config server. So as we saw here, we have defined this configuration inside our application.yml file. And as we know, application.yml file is used for the application context container. And whenever we are starting application context, Spring Boot will use the application.yml file. But for to getting all the cloud configuration, there is we need to add bootstrap.yml file, because this file will be used to bootstrap the configuration and then it will start the application and load the application YML file after that. So now we will create one more file, that is bootstrap.yml file in each microservice that want to communicate with config server. So here I will just create one more file. So file bootstrap.yml file. And now I will go to our application.yml file and copy this configuration from here and add in our bootstrap.yml file, and here we just need to remove spring cloud config enabled. So I will go to our application.yml file and we will remove it from here, and we'll also remove from other microservices, that is catalog service. Here I will also remove from here, and one is our API gateway microservices. Inside the service we have already added, so we will remove it from here also. So now we have removed, and now I will go to our store service where we have created our bootstrap.yml file. So I will copy this file and added this file into our catalog service, and we also need to add this file inside our API gateway YML file inside our API gateway project. So we have added. Now we need to start our application again. So first I will start our service registry, stop it and start it again. And after starting this microservice, that is service registry, we need to start our other microservices, that is catalog service. And service कैटालॉग सर्विस दैट इज जावा एप्लीकेशन. ओके सो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू स्टार्ट इट एंड गो टू आवर स्टोर सर्विस एंड स्टार्ट इट आल्सो. Now I need to start our API gateway also. So first stop this and start this microservice also. And one more service that is config server that we also need to start. So I will just go and here config server application. So here we can check on console output if our microservices is working, running. So now I will go to Eureka server and will check here. So here we can see catalog service is working, config service, store service, but our API gateway service is not running. So we need to check why it's not working. Failed to start, found our class was with Spring Cloud Gateway. So we need to check it why it's not running. So here I am just getting errors to start my API gateway. So it's suggesting me please set Spring main web reactive type. Main web application type is equal to reactive, so I will copy it here and go to my application.yml file, and here I just need to search for Spring. Under Spring I will just add main. Under main we just need to add web application type and it will be reactive. So now I will try to start this application again. So here now we can see our application has started at port number 8082, that is API gateway. Now I will go to browser and Eureka, I will check. And here we can see our API gateway has registered and catalog services and config service and store service for microservices has been registered, and we have already removed the common configuration for each microservices, that is application.yml we have removed as a Eureka client. But we can see here these are Eureka client, so it's getting the configuration from our config server. So now here we can see on Eureka server, config server microservices is also registered, and now we can test our get catalog API if it is working or not. So here I will just call first store, get store by ID. Need to check we have started our store service, but we are not getting the response. So here we are getting 404 not found, means our common configuration is not able to read. So we will go and check our config server, and inside config server we have not defined our URI. So here we need to go and go to our GitHub repository and copy this path from here and go to our configuration server and paste it here. So now stop this server again and start it again, and then we need to check it again. So here we can see updating port 8083 and application has started. Now go to Postman and need to hit same REST endpoint again. And again getting 404. So I think we also need to remove application dot properties here and start it again if it works. So I have just updated my Maven dependency in API Gateway, and after that I have hit the same endpoint, that is localhost 8082. That port is used by API Gateway and sending this request, and now I am getting the proper response. So here now we are reading our common configuration for our GitHub repository that we have defined here, and we have defined this URI path in our config server application.yml file. So after configuring the common configuration server for each microservice, now we need to implement log tracing for microservice. So now we will learn how to implement log tracing in microservice to track the request. So here we will use Zipkin or Solyth library for distributed log tracing. For example, if we have 100 of microservices and we are calling one REST endpoint of any microservices, and this request is traversing through multiple microservices. So to trace that request, we can use the Zipkin and Solyth distributed logging system. Otherwise, it will be very difficult to track the request and to check in which microservice request was failed. And the log format printed by Zipkin server is like service name, and second parameter will be trace ID, and third will be span ID. So trace ID will be generated per request and span ID will be generated per microservice. So we can track the request by trace ID and span ID, and trace ID will be remain same for single request if it is traversing through multiple microservices, and span ID will be unique for each microservice. So to implement Zipkin and Solyth in our microservice architecture, we need Zipkin server. So we need to implement Zipkin client and Solyth in our all microservices. So okay, let's start first our Zipkin server. First I will go to browser here and we'll just type download Zipkin. Now just click on quick start, open Zipkin, and here we can see in this section we just need to download the jar file. So here I will click on latest release. So now here our Zipkin jar file has downloaded. Now we just need to run our jar. So here I will just go and enter cmd, and here we just need to jar java-jar, need to run the jar, and the name of the jar is Zipkin. So z and tab and run it. So our Zipkin server has started, and we can see it has been started at port number 9411. So now I will go to browser and open this port. So here I will go and type http 127.0.0.1 9411. So here we can see it is our Zipkin server. So once I will click on plus icon, so here we can see service name, but here if I run the query, there is no service registered. Now what we need to do, now we need to implement Zipkin client and Solyth in our all microservice. Then we can see here our all microservice. So we will just implement our Zipkin client and Solyth in our only two microservice. One is store service and second is catalog service. So first I will go to our store service, and first we need to add logs. So here I will go and open the service implementation layer, and we'll add few logs. So we can check. So here I will just add annotation, that is @self4j. And after adding this annotation, S will be capital. Now we just need to add the logs. So here I will just add log.info. And here we just need to add creating store. and next we can use here what we are doing, finding the store by id, finding the store by id, finding the store by id. So here we will just print the id. Like this we will add the logs in our catalog service implementation only. We are just adding few logs. So here I will go to my catalog service and will open its service IMPL layer. And this is service IMPL class catalog. And here what I will do, just adding the logs. And here what we need to do, at class level we just need to define the annotation, that is at the rate self4j. So after that we just need to change finding the catalog by id. And here we can see we are creating the catalog, creating the catalog. So like this we can add multiple loggers, but we are just adding only few loggers in our service IMPL class. So as we know, our request will be traversed through both the microservices if we will hit get catalog by id. So first request will goes to catalog service IMPL, then it will internally calling to service service store API get store by id. Now after adding logs, now we need to add configuration inside our store service and catalog service. So I will go to our application.yml file, and here we just need to add few configurations, that is Spring Zipkin. Zipkin and base URL we need to define where our Zipkin server is running. So here I will just define base hyphen URL, and we need to copy the URL, that is http://127.0.0.1, and the port number is 9411. So I will copy both properties from here and go to my catalog service IMPL. And we'll paste same configuration here also in application.yml file. So here I will just go to application. So we have added the configuration for Zipkin server here inside catalog, and also added in our service store. But we have added some at wrong place. So we just need to add in our application.yml file. So here I will go and just paste it again. So now I will stop my store service and start it again. And like this, we also need to stop our catalog service and need to restart it again. So stop it and run it again. And here we can see our application has started, and also need to check our store service. If it is running, yes, it has also started. So I will clear the logs and now go to Postman and will hit the same REST endpoint get catalog by ID. So here we are getting the response. Now we need to check the logs. So here we can see logs were not added. So we also need to add the dependency for Zipkin and Selenium in our store service and catalog service pom.xml. So first I will go to catalog service pom.xml file, and here we need to add the library for Zipkin and Selenium. So first I will open the start.spring.io, and here we just need to add these two dependencies. So here I will search for Zipkin and we'll add the Zipkin client dependency, and second we need to add Selenium. So here we have added both dependencies. Now I will go and explore. And here we just need to copy. So here I will just search for our Zipkin and sleuth-maven dependency. Both is here. So we just need to copy. And now I will go to my store service and catalog service. First I will add in our catalog service. So these are the two dependencies that I have added now. Now I will go to store service and we'll add same dependencies in store service also. So here I will go to pom.xml and inside our dependencies we just need to add two dependencies here also. So after adding these two dependencies, now we need to restart our catalog service and store service. So now I will start my catalog service after adding the Maven dependency in pom.xml and we'll also start. So here we can see catalog service and it is separated by comma, trace ID and span ID. So when I will hit any REST API, then we will check its trace ID and span ID. And then we will identify if it is same or different for each request. So now I will start our store service. So now our both services has been started. So first I will clear the logs from store service and as well as on catalog service. So now I will go to Postman and will hit the REST endpoint get catalog by ID. So this request will traverse through both the microservice. First to catalog, after that it will goes to store. So sending request and getting the response. Now we need to check the logs. So here I will go to catalog service and we can see the format of logs, that is catalog service, and this is our trace ID. So trace ID will be same for single request. So first it was goes to our catalog service IMPL. After that, it was goes to our store service IMPL. So here we need to check control F and search it here. So here we can see it's traversing here. So trace ID will be same, but the span ID will be different because it is related to each microservice. So like this, we can trace the request in multiple microservices and can verify which microservices was failed. So this was all about basic architecture of microservices. Okay, thanks for watching this video.